नमस्ते लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, प्रोफेशनल्स इन वेरियस डोमेन्स। नाउ आई वुड वॉन्ट टू टेक दिस सब्जेक्ट मच फर्दर टू द नेक्स्ट लेवल। So far I was talking about what exactly this mind, body and soul it works and all. I was going getting into that theoretical aspects and all. Let's try getting into the conceptual understanding forever. Conceptual understanding, and we will see what really is that one thing that motivated rishis and munis to write shastras. And let's try analyzing shastras from two different views. The point is, the moment we talk about shastras from the viewpoint of Shashvata Satya and Ashashvata Satya, Shashvata Satya is something which exists in universe and it remains forever, and it is useful for one and all to manage or to take the life or to grow in his or her own life. Let's talk about Ashashvata Satya. Ashashvata Satya's emergence came into picture because most of the seers, rishis and munis had that divine intuition which was telling that this universe is going to take changes for every 500 years or 600 years. Thus, whatever philosophy or theology that we are presenting will be obsolete. So let's divide this and let's see which is Shashvata Satya and Ashashvata Satya. So thus what happened was, Brahma Sutras were created in view of understanding Brahmanda, Indanda, Pindanda concept. Ishvara Satya, when we talk about Ishvara Satya, it talks about Srishti Laya Jati Gati, and the Srishti is based on the 36 tattvas which predominantly is to be understood by one and all. Now we are talking about Brahmanda, Indanda, Pindanda, Brahma Satya, Ishvara Satya. Now the Vishnu part. This is what is called Brahma Granthi, Rudra Granthi and Vishnu Granthi. Vishnu Granthi, if we talk or if we really look at it, more or less talks about the beauty part, beauty of the existence. Existence from the universal point of view. Now, if universe is beautified and beautiful things are there, obviously one needs to enjoy it, right? So, Brahma had to create living beings. Now, after creating living beings, let's talk about the opposite sex, masculine and feminine. Feminine again more or less talks about the beautification part. Feminine is more or less like concentrates on the external beauty. That is the reason why you see most of the ladies, when they dress up, they look very beautiful, which really has to be understood. However, when it comes to masculine, masculine is again like male who is responsible for the universe cycle to move on. Now, this is where one needs to understand, when male and female, masculine and feminine conjugate together, they come into contact, that's when zygote is formed in the girl's womb, female's womb. And that's the beauty of feminine nature. Now, why all of this was done, or why all of this is, why this conjugation, conjugal happening of masculine and feminine was needed. If we really look at, we need to understand this cycle has to move on. It's one cycle. It finishes with one family cycle. And that's when you understand the beauty's true definition. With limitations, not crossing the boundaries. And that's where Kama Sutra came into picture. Vatsayana created a doctrine called Kama Sutra, which had the divinity and certain guidelines. The point is, as the years and centuries rolled by, all these shastras which I am talking about, the Shashvata Satyas which I am talking about, got diluted. When I say diluted, diluted. They were filled with Ashashvata Satyas. Now, coming to the point, if we look at sutras or the stories or whatever that are being enacted in the art form, बीट क्लासिकल डांस और सेमी क्लासिकल डांस और थिएटर और द आर्टिस्ट और एनी मीडिया. इट्स अगेन डिवाइडेड इनटू आरण्यकास, संहितास एंड ब्राह्मणास एंड बृहदारण्यकास. इफ वी रियली लुक एट दीज आर द कैटेगरीज ऑफ द स्टोरीज और द स्टोरी लाइन दैट वॉज सपोज टू बी टेकन. नाउ लेट्स ट्राई गेटिंग इन टू अदर सब्जेक्ट पार्ट. देर आर थ्री कांडास, दे आर थ्री कैटेगरीज ऑफ द फिलॉसफी, विच इज ब्रह्मकांड, ज्ञानकांड, उपासना कांड. नाउ वाई दिस ब्रह्मकांड, ज्ञानकांड, उपासना कांड केम इन टू पिक्चर. इन ब्रह्मकांड इट टॉक्स अबाउट ब्रह्मांड, इंडांड, पिंडांड. वॉट इज दिस ब्रह्मन कॉन्शियसनेस ऑल अबाउट? हाउ इट एक्सपैंड्स? वॉट इज दिस ब्रह्मन? वॉट इज दिस ब्राह्मण कॉन्शियसनेस एज अ होल? वाई दिस यूनिवर्स वॉज क्रिएटेड? वॉज ब्रह्मा रियली एग्जिस्टिंग? इज इट दैट रियली विच इज नीडेड? एंड दैट इंक्लूड्स अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ ब्रह्मणिज्म एंड ब्रह्मणिकल राइट्स. This is very interesting point and very important point and vital point from the Natyashastra's point of view. This is where Bharata emphasized on understanding Brahmanism and Brahmanical rites. One needs to really understand Brahmakanda. Coming to the Jnanakanda. Jnanakanda again more or less talks about knowledge part, knowledge which is what is necessary for the human existence as a whole, which one needs to really understand. At the same time, it has to be that this knowledge, whatever that we are learning, is of some use to the society. That is the reason why it is called Jnanakanda, or else it would have been called as Ajnanakanda. Upasanakanda. Upasanakanda again deals with the rituals. What kind of upasana that you are doing? What kind of rituals that you are following on a day-to-day basis? As a part of practice or the religion. Now let's get much further to the subject. The earlier part of Vedas, maybe 10,000 years back, when Nasadiya Sukta or Hiranyagarbha Sukta was there, had the information about Adityas, Rudras, and daityas, which again pertains to karma kanda. And this is what we talk as karma, karma siddhanta, karma philosophy. Now why this, what are these adityas or Adityas or Rudras or Daityas we are talking about? This Adityas are again into divided into 12 parts. That is the reason why we say say them as Dwadasha Aditya. This Dwadasha Aditya again works in parallel to the human existence. This human existence, till the time he or she is alive, has to live for 12 months, which is equal to 12 houses, which is what is told in astrology. I do not want to get into that astrology part because I am not so much aware of it. However, I will cover that part later. This is just the brief information that I am giving. So, Adityas are basically 12 houses. Now, the 9 planets that are there, which we are hypothetically talking from the sorry about that, from the science point of view, that they exist in above the universe, and they act, and their presence is felt. However, here is where we need to understand. Here is where the Rudras, the 11 Rudras or Ekadasha Rudra, Om Namo Bhagavate Rudraya, now these Rudras help us to control, take control over your indriyas, and our body is the constitutes of Dwadasha Adityas and Daityas. We have 12 Adityas in our body, and the 9 planets that I am talking about work in the form of 7 chakras, Shat chakras, that is what we say. Now, coming to the point of Shashvata Satya, whatever that I am talking about, this is the Shashvata Satya. Shashvata means permanent truth. Now, if we see till the end of 10,000 years back, when I was talking about 10,000 years back, situation was totally different. Situation was absolutely fine, and we had a very good environment, and we could really like have that kind of you know, situation where we could concentrate on things. It's like Satya Yuga, Dwapar Yuga. Again, that is dependent on the Yugas. If I take considering 11 Rudras again talks about the 108 Karnas. That is again based on the Rudras. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. I will tell you why I am explaining all of these in the last. After 10,000 years, the Upanishads were heard by seers, rishis and munis. Now, when I say heard, it was like Megha Sandesha, sky responding, or these rishis, munis or seers had that intuitive mind to get it connected to that universe. Today it's very 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 negligible, and I would rather say next to nothing to find that sort of person in these sorts of categories. If you find also, they will not talk to you, you would not be able to understand. Now, these are the real words of the universe or Shruti, which is heard by the seers, rishis and munis. Now this Shruti that I am talking about, after some time, it was not recorded message or whatever it is. Emergence came into situation. Then Ashashvata Satya came into picture. When I say Ashashvata Satya, it included giving the brief gist of this Brahma Kanda, Jnana Kanda, Upasana Kanda and Karma Kanda, which is giving the information about Adityas, Rudras and Daityas. And this has to be told in the form of stories. Again, stories come from, as I told you, Aranyakas, Samhitas, Brahmanas and Brihad Aranyakas. Now, just because one is having this and all, right, we have to express that. Am I correct? So, this is where Ashashvata Satya came into picture and story was created. Now, the point is, Yes, sir, you are talking all of this well and good. I could understand, we could understand. How do you show this, or how do you how do you share this knowledge or whatever that is there? Then came Navanida Bhakti. Yoga Shastra, Yoga, Yoga Meditation and Art and Culture, Fine Arts and Culture, Natya Shastra came into picture. Natya was one means wherein you do that enactment by empathizing on the characters. Here is where we exhibit Brahma Kanda, Jnana Kanda, Upasana Kanda and Karma Kanda. And whatever that has been heard by the seers or rishis or munis, by translating that voice that came through air, in simple terms, using the words or the Shruti that came, this was established. As a bit of it is Ashashvata Satya and a bit of it is Shashvata Satya. One had to add Ashashvata Satya for a simple reason that, see, all time the philosophy people will get bored, right? So one needs to add small bit of story or whatever it is. So that's where the Ashashvata Satya came, exaggeration. Thus, this is where the Natya Shastra's introductory part came into picture, and this is how, this is the brief gist. However, as a part of note and disclaimer, I may be right, I may be wrong, but still this is an attempt एंड दिस इज माई एजम्पशन और माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग. आई एम नॉट कमिंग टू द कंक्लूसिव conclusion at all. This is just my understanding. I may be right, I may be wrong. I am also a human being. I am expecting viewers, patrons, scholars to correct me wherever I have gone wrong. It's a kind of request. Please. This is just an attempt to educate as to how these shastras came into existence and came into being and what exactly motivated. Thus, I conclude this video with the pointers understanding of existence and coexistence of shastras from the Shashvata Satya and Ashashvata Satya point of view. I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Have a nice day ahead. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. May the Guru's grace be with you all. Have a nice day ahead.